We keep on winning this week, and let's look to do that again today with soccer and baseball. Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Jason Mattis with Winning Bets. Thanks for kicking off your morning with me here on Winning Bets as we give out free sports picks every single day. And that's right, yesterday was another profitable day as Monday was profitable, Tuesday was profitable, and yesterday was profitable as we went 3-1 and plus 1.47 units. That now brings us to the total now of plus 2.67 units. Just congratulations to everybody. Really happy and thrilled for you guys. Go ahead and hit that like button if you were part of yesterday's cash as well. On that 3-1 day, we started off having PSG get more cards than Manchester City. That was awesome. I mean, they did it. It went about how we talked about here on the show. Dirty PSG. Took a while for Dirty PSG to show up, but, you know, Manchester City got a shit goal. I mean that was a shitty goal. I mean, their first goal, that was definitely a cross into the box that De Bruyne whips in there, hoping somebody gets on the end of it. The keeper is, you know, anticipating somebody doing that, so he's flat-footed, and the ball, you know, misses everybody and happens to curl in the back of the net. And I knew it. As soon as that goal went in, it wasn't that Manchester City scored. I mean, I knew, based on how that game was going, I was like, I need a goal to get PSG to be dirty. But just the fact that they gave up a really shitty goal, boy, I knew dirty PSG was going to show up after that, and that's exactly what happened. They went like bang, bang, two quick yellows, and then a handful of minutes after that, they ended up getting a red card. I mean, yeah, it just was absolutely awesome. So that was a good job by us. 2-0 this week in Champions League, and both of those bets were at plus money. So just a nice, fantastic day in the Champions League. We rolled that over in the nightcap. Major League Baseball, Royals went over their team total of 3.5. They got three runs in the first inning and ended up getting their fourth run in the third inning. So a nice, easy, no sweat cash there for us in that Royals team total. Then we did our no run first inning parlay. It ended up being a two-legged parlay because one of the legs got rained out. So DraftKings scored it at minus 195. That's why we didn't have as much profit today as we would anticipate on a normal 3-1 day with one of those legs getting rained out. But doesn't matter though. The other two legs came through for us there. So we got a nice win there. No run the first inning. Then the triple of the day was the Mets on the run line. I mean, just the Mets could not solve Pivetta, which is really of a huge shocker. I mean, just look at his numbers. He's been getting hit all season long. So, you know, definitely a shocker and a head-scratcher that the Mets couldn't scrape across some runs because DeGrom was doing DeGrom things out there and absolutely shut down the Red Sox, only giving up one run. Just another stellar performance there by DeGrom. But still, 3-1 on the day and plus 1.47 units. Never going to complain with putting money in everybody's pocket. That's exactly what we did yesterday, as we've been doing every day this week. You know, I've been going through these shows. I know we do the MLB Underdogs recap on Mondays, but usually, you know, I usually sprinkle in little updates there throughout the week when the MLB Underdogs do good. Well, I need to be fair to the favorites and at least give out a little, you know, blurb here to the favorites. Underdogs got their ass kicked yesterday. Absolutely got their ass kicked. There were 14 MLB games, and the Underdogs were only able to win three of those games. So, tough day there for the MLB Underdogs. And, of course, we'll do the full recap of that on Monday. Just, you know, I wanted to be fair to the favorites. I always tout when the Underdogs do good. Not a good day for the Underdogs yesterday. Let's do give out some free money, though, on the NBC Sports Predictor app. We did our pick and roll contest there last night in the NBA. We had four people tied with 25 points. Just a really good showing. Super competitive week by a lot of us there. A lot of 20s. And then you know, they're obviously right behind the 25s. But, yeah, just a real good competitive week. That was nice to see, and congratulations to everybody. But who took home the money was Thad, S. Lowry 7, K. Barsby, and Living Legend all took home the money. And these are all repeat winners. So congratulations to all four of them. All four of them have won these contests on maybe different, maybe not the NBA pick and roll, but, you know, they've all won contests on this app. So certainly congratulations, you know, to all four of them. And I've already got all four of y'all's information. I'll go ahead and drop each of you $5. $5. So that's prize is obviously $20, but we got a four-way tie, so $5 a piece. But, yeah, congratulations. Make that $5 grow, guys. Make some crazy-ass parlay. Make some crazy-ass parlay and share it with me on Twitter or drop it here on YouTube. Do some crazy-ass parlay with that $5. Do it. I want to see it hit. I want to see the big boy hit. You always see these parlays that FanDuel and DraftKings, their Twitter accounts, they show it. They always share these like crazy, like 10 legs. Somebody puts like $2 on a 10-legged parlay, wins like a grand. I would wet myself if I did that. Like, I'd be so happy to pull out a 10-legged parlay. Can't do it. Can't do it. So I want you guys to do it. Make that $5 grow. All right, quick recap here. Got two Europa League bets. Gave these out, obviously, yesterday. Just want to put them in front of you guys just as a very quick recap. Manchester United over 1.5 goals at minus 121. And Manchester United over 54.5 possession at minus 118. My boys are in action today. I'm going to be nervous. Not nervous, because obviously I think, you know, we're going to win. I think we'll win pretty comfortably. But just semifinal, Europa League, going to be a nervous watch there. But, let's just it's always nervous when your team's up and, you know, yeah, let's go, Man U. Let's go, Man U. I'm not betting Villarreal, Arsenal, but if I was, I would bet both teams to score in that game. But I am not betting it. My money is not behind it, so take it where you will. But if I was betting it, I would do both teams to score in Villarreal and Arsenal. That being said, lineup depending. Need to see who's on the pitch there for Arsenal. Don't really know the Villarreal players, but they got Unai Emery, the Europa League king. So not really worried about who Villarreal's got, but I am worried a little bit what Arsenal's got. So while I would both teams to score, I would need to see lineups. If you want to hit me up on Twitter after lineups come out at 1 p.m. Central Time and get my opinion, I will certainly give you my opinion if you ask for it on Twitter. But again, I am not betting that, so do that one at your own risk. I am betting Major League Baseball today, and I'm going to go another no-run the first inning parlay, just like we got yesterday's cash. Going to do three games and only do half innings in each of those games. We're going to go right back to that Tigers game. That was one that got rained out there, so we're going to take Tigers not to score in the first inning. Again, I already justified that one yesterday because we were on that. That was just the rainout game. Then we're going to do Brewers not to score in the first inning. They're going up against Trevor Bauer. We all know Trevor Bauer, super elite pitcher there in Major League Baseball. And then I'm also going to do the Mariners not to score in the first inning. They're opposed on the bump by Luis Garcia. This guy's almost striking out one batter per inning. So absolutely love that. You need guys that have good strikeout stuff in this position in case they do get in a jam. This guy's got that. And the Mariners on the season are only scoring 0.29 runs per first inning. So yeah, an offense that's obviously not coming out of the gates strong at all. So got no problem backing Luis Garcia for this three-legged parlay. So Tigers not to score in the first inning, Brewers not to score in the first inning, and Mariners also not scoring the first inning. And as you can see, that parlay comes in at plus 106. So love that it's coming in there at plus money right there. One other bet I'm just going to get in front of you guys, and look for me on Twitter to officially announce it, but I wanted to let you know that this is on my radar. It's just the sportsbooks don't have it yet. You guys remember the first time this season that the Yankees went up against the Orioles with Jordan Montgomery on there? I told you guys I wanted to do Jordan Montgomery's K prop, and depending on what the number came in at, if it came in at, I think it was 6.5, I was going to stay off of it. It came in at 5.5. I wasn't going to bet it. Well, it came in at 6.5, so I didn't end up betting it. But even though I thought 6.5 was a little too risky for my blood. Well, Thad actually hit me up on Twitter that day and said, you know, liked your analysis on Montgomery being able to get, you know, a handful of strikeouts. Thad hit me up on Twitter. He did Montgomery either to have like 4+ strikeouts or 5+ strikeouts, and they do a double player performance, I think is what it's called there on FanDuel, where you take a player's performance and parlay that essentially with the money line. So that's what he did, like Montgomery 4+ Ks or maybe 5+ Ks and parlay that with the Yankees money line. I absolutely love that bet that he did there, so I'm going to do that. Jordan Montgomery's strikeout total today is over under 4.5. So if they give us that at Montgomery at 4+, and I'm not going to do it at 5+. 5+ is a touch too risky for me. But at 4+, if it's Montgomery at 4+, parlay that with the Yankee money line. If that's the player double performance, I'm going to be all over that. So maybe, or not maybe, so definitely look for me on Twitter. If I see that prop bet and pull the trigger, you can find me on Twitter to go ahead and pull that one. Montgomery to have 4+ Ks, and the Yankees to pull out another victory. They've been smashing the Orioles. Too bad they didn't smash the Orioles in game one against Matt Harvey. That still irritates the shit out of me, but the Yankees bats have definitely woken up the last two games. They got a 5-1 win, and they got a 7-0 win yesterday. They haven't even thrown Aroldis Chapman yet in this series, so their good arms are ready to go if this game is even close and competitive there. So yeah, definitely like the Yankees to win. They're going up against Lopez is on the mound for the Orioles. This guy's shitty. He's given up 6 home runs and 4 starts. Everybody he goes up against is absolutely tagging him. So yeah, love the bet. Just obviously the Yankees, you know, money line is juiced too much. That's why I'm trying to parlay it with Montgomery's performance. And I definitely like Montgomery to get 4 strikeouts. And the fact that they've got that over-under at 4.5, I think we'll be able to parlay it with Montgomery 4+ Ks. But again, just look for me on Twitter there to pull the trigger. That game's at noon Central Time. So hopefully they populate that bet here. I mean, I would imagine in the next couple hours we'll be able to get that bet populated on FanDuel. So yeah, just look for me here very shortly before noon Central Time when that game kicks off, and we'll hopefully add that bet to our two soccer bets, our no run the first inning parlay, and we'll have 4 bets total there. And let's continue the winning ways on winning bets. That's what we've been doing this week, and I'm so happy for you guys. You guys are putting money in your pocket. Come back on Friday's show. We'll recap these bets and we'll kick off our weekend slate of bets. Have a good one, guys. Thanks for watching this episode of Winning Bets. I'm Jason Mattis. I'll see you again when we are celebrating the wins and making more winning bets. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe for more winning bets.